Hey there, calamity type people. How's it going? My name is Connor. Achoo! How did my link get there? That was weird, wasn't it? That my link, I sneezed out my link. How's it going? I know what all of you are thinking, because I'm inside of your heads. I know what you all are thinking, and it's this.
She doesn't even go here.
There's just one problem with your statement. I'm a male, for one, so she doesn't even go. I'm a guy, so it's he doesn't even go here. But yeah, I don't even go here. You guys don't know who I am. Maybe some of you do, which is cool. Hi. But most of you don't know who I am. But my buddy, Ashley Mardell, who you're supposed to be seeing today, came to me and asked me, I'm just gonna try and do my best Ashley Mardell right here. Hey, Connor, I need you to do a video for me because I can't post on Calamity Central. I just wanted to be really emphatic and gesture towards the camera like she does. She's wonderful. I love her so much. But yeah, she asked me to do this for her because she can't do it, so I'm doing this for her. And yeah, so she tells me that the theme for this one is embarrassing stories. And boy, do I have a doozy McDoozerton for you folks. Unfortunately, it's not very recent because it's impossible to really embarrass me now because I do YouTube videos now. That's about as embarrassing as that's rock bottom in the embarrassing world. And I'm not even embarrassed by it. So this is a story from my past, from my deepest, darkest childhood. Yeah. But let me take you back, if you will, to about age 3 Connor version. He's much more adorable than he is now, which I know you're like, what? How? How could he be more adorable? But he was. He had blonde ringlets, you know? All the ladies loved him because they thought he was a lady, so they were gonna try and befriend him and make him one of the gals. That's what my life was like. But anyway, I was at this party, right? With my fam. Was just chilling at this party. And, you know, I wasn't hanging with the adults, you know? I was, you know, with the cool kids. And by the cool kids, I was with two chicks, you know? Because I was the 3-year-old little player, you know? Just doing what I do best. And me and these two girls thought it would be a great idea to start jumping off stairs, because, you know, who doesn't like to jump off stairs? I like to live life on the edge, and I've always liked to live life on the edge, even when I was a toddler. I like to toddle on the edge. That's how I did things. Yeah, we were just, like, jumping off stairs, you know, being reckless, because we're young and reckless. That's how we do things. And then me, being the competitive whatever I am, I wanted to step it up a notch. And not just a notch, a couple notches, and by notches, I mean stairs, because I kept going higher on the stairs. And so I first jumped off 2 stairs, nailed it, killed it, you know, and I noticed that it was impressing the girls, so what do? I push it farther. That's what men do. That's what courting is. It's just pushing yourself so far and hoping you don't make a fool out of yourself. I made that mistake. And then I went to 3 stairs, jumped off it, nailed it again. And here's where things started to get real, because then I pushed it up to 4 stairs, jumping off and landing on the floor, right? And I'm 3 years old at this point. 3. Trace, that's only 3. And I jumped off the 4 stairs, right? And broke my foot in 3 places. Destroyed my foot. It was awful. It was horrible. One of my first memories because it was so bad. I was just trying to impress the ladies and I destroyed my foot. That's what happened. However, I will point out that it didn't work in the short term. I didn't pick them up then. But here's what happened. About 12 or 13 years down the road, I end up dating one of these girls who was at this situation that happened. So it was a long-term investment that eventually paid off. But I will recommend this to you if you're 3 years old. Why are you on YouTube? But if you're 3 years old, don't jump off steps to impress women, because you will have a bad time. And we don't want to have a bad time. But yeah, that's my embarrassing story, I guess. I hope y'all enjoyed it, even though I'm not supposed to be here. I'm not supposed to be here. I thought I would do this, you know, for a friend, you know, help her out and stuff, yeah? If you liked watching me, check out my stuff. It's in the description area. I would love to have you over at my business, Majigger. And yeah, I think I'm gonna leave now. This was fun. I enjoyed it very much. I enjoyed it very much. But I'm gonna leave now. Later, kiddos.
She doesn't even go here.